I got a question, Claude.
Yes, sir.
Can we do a role play on
role plays? I don't, you know how I feel about role plays.
That's right, that's right. I think you and I feel the same.
I love role plays. They're fun. They make you strong. What do you have in mind?
You got a prospect, very emotional, starts like crying, has given you a commitment, but then, you know, starts crying and obfuscating almost and starts to think that, doesn't want to sign the contract or cries and like, I need to do it, but I can. It's such an emotional transaction.
I don't want you to do anything you're not comfortable with. You know, we had a great discussion. You told me A, B, C, D, and E. You told me you can't afford it. You're behind in payments. You got a transfer. You got a new job. Your kid, you want to be closer to your grandkids. You told me all these things, and I'm ready to do business with you today. But if you're not comfortable, are we done? Is it over, sir?
No, it's not over, Claude. I need.
Then what is it, sir? I'm confused. Help me out.
I need to sell it, Claude. But I
want to buy it. Let's do it.
It's my mother's house, and it's such an emotional thing to me. And I just
it's so freaking sad.
I don't know. My brother, he didn't pay the mortgage, and I got to sell it, but it's just hard. I don't know.
Sir, I understand your situation. I've been there myself. A lot of people are going through that right now. I can be part of the problem or part of the success. I mean, can you imagine if you and I do a deal today and this property and the stress and all the money issues are behind you tonight when you have dinner with your lovely family and you tell them, you know what? I made a decision. I manned up. I made a decision. Problems are over. It's not perfect. But we can move forward now and remove all that stress and anxiety from our lives. Imagine if you could do that for a moment at dinner tonight. How would you feel?
I'd feel like a weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I've made a decision, sir. You want to know what it is?
What is it?
We're going to do a deal. I'm going to send you a contract. You're going to get it back to me before 12:30, and you're going to live happily. You made a good adult decision. It's not perfect, but it's a decision, and it allows you to move forward. You're a young man. You'll do other deals. You'll have other properties. You can't go through life with all that stress. And if you want to say no to me, God bless you. But if you want to move forward and have a resolution to these issues, I'm ready to make an offer right now. Can we do that?
Yes. Yes. Let's do it, Claude.
I'm sorry, what?
Let's send it over. I'm going to sign it. It's just so hard, Claude, but you know what?
You're a young, intelligent man. You'll come back. These are the obstacles we have in life. Are you going to go down with the Titanic and join the orchestra, or are you going to move forward and get in the rowboat?
I'm going to get in the rowboat.
There you go, sir. That's a decision. Good for you. Boom. Was that what you were looking for?
That's what I was looking for, Claude.
You know me, I'm over the top. I want an Academy Award or something, okay? I'd like to thank my mother and father today for bottom line. What did you take away? You saw a lot of different psychological triggers that I used besides bad acting. What were they?
Mainly emotion. You got them. You didn't go with logic or anything like that. You went with the emotional side, which psychological triggers would be. Help me out, somebody.
You made it. He made a decision for you. I think that's the biggest thing. People want to be led, and I think that's the biggest thing that I see in the way I took it, Claude, is that you made a decision for him. And you want it, and people naturally want to be led. I think that's the best way I can put it.
Say that again, Michael. Thank you.
People want to be led.
They like assertiveness. When people make not bullying, but they love assertiveness sometimes when they feel you're sincere and have it in their best interest. Did I give them room to escape? Listen, it's okay to say no. I mean, it was what Mr. Cashroff was saying. It was very emotional, but I did intercede intersect, excuse me, a little bit of logic. You told me you're moving, you're behind in payments, you got a new house, you got a new job, you want to be closer to your grandkids. You've got to find the needs and greeds and intertwine them with the emotion, and you become a very dangerous professional salesperson. Very dangerous. That was a great role. Give Chris a round of applause. That was a great thing.